Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I am going to help you go vegan in under 10 minutes. So I'm gonna talk a little fast, I have a lot to fit in. If you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe and give this video a thumbs up and let's get into the video. So first off, let's set some ground rules. When you're vegan, that basically means that you eat no animal products. I also do not buy any animal products to wear or to use on my skin or in makeup. Fully vegan all around. However, a lot of you, if you're just new to the vegan lifestyle, maybe you're just gonna start with the food thing. So in this video, I'm not gonna be talking about vegan clothes and makeup and all those things, just food. So the first thing you need to do when you're going vegan, especially if you wanna make this a long-term lifestyle, is you need to have a plan that you can follow. You also need to know your why. So why are you becoming vegan? Is it because you've learned about the plight of animals in the agriculture system? Or is it because you know that being vegan is so much better for the environment? Or maybe it's just 100% for your health. But whatever it is, have a plan, know your why, and you will succeed. I get so many emails from people asking me, how do you become vegan, Janae? Please send me some recipes. Please send me some tips. But really what you need to start off is a meal plan and a meal prep guide. You need to meal prep because if you're meal prepped, then you will always have food to eat. You'll always know what you're gonna eat. And the meal plan comes first because that meal plan will help you structure what I'm gonna eat for breakfast, what I'm gonna eat for lunch, what I'm gonna eat for snacks and for dinner or whatever other, I mean, I guess that's all you eat, isn't it? Snacks, breakfast, lunch, dinner, maybe a few snacks. Anyway, a meal plan will certainly help. Then the meal prep comes into play because once you have your meal plan, you need to actually prep that food. Now, if you're like most of us and you're busy, you have a job, you have kids, you're spending a lot of time watching Netflix, whatever it is, you will have so much more success if you meal prep, meaning you'll take one or maybe two or maybe even 3 days throughout your week to just cook a lot of food that you can eat in the coming days. Another tip for your meal plan, if this is totally a new lifestyle for you, make sure you have some meals on your meal plan that you already know and love, but the veganized version. And it could be anything. It could be burgers, lasagna, spaghetti, tacos, burritos, whatever. You can veganize it. Eating 80-20. So 80-20, let me give you a little background what that is. 80% wholesome, unprocessed fruits and vegetables and legumes and all that good stuff. And the 20% can be junk food, processed food, things that you feel like I shouldn't really be eating this, but oh my God, it's so delicious. 20%, no more. If you can do less, that's great too. But don't go over 20%, ideally, because there's so much goodness, so many benefits, nutritional benefits in that 80%, the wholesome foods. And I promise you, as you go along and as you try more recipes, you'll be able to make the 80%, so the wholesome vegetables and fruits and beans and such, you'll be able to make it as delicious as the 20%. I also should say that your taste buds will change. So if you're coming to the vegan diet as a person who's been eating a standard American diet for a long time or your whole life, then your taste buds will need time to change because these are just, they're new flavors to you. But just like you've been accustomed to eating whatever you've been eating your whole life, you will become accustomed to eating vegan food, to eating plants, to eating different spices. So, you know, those are all malleable. Don't think just because I like Oreos and Popeyes and Papa John's that you're only gonna like that for the rest of your life. Those things can change. Take your vitamins. First off, B12. B12 is very important because if you're eating animal products, you're getting that from the animal food. And animals, they don't produce it on their own. B12 is actually created and synthesized from a bacteria that they get from eating their food, which in nature that comes from eating soil or, you know, eating grass that has soil on it, which has that bacteria on it. So if you're eating a vegan plant-based diet, you're gonna have to take a B12 supplement. Super simple, I'll link the one that I like to use down below. I also recommend taking a vitamin D supplement. Just make sure that when you get your vitamin D, you're finding a vegan source. You can find a vegan alternative that comes from lichen. But for me, just to make everything easier in the vitamin supplement front, I just take a multivitamin from Ritual, which I will also link below along with a little discount code. I've been taking that one for probably 2 years now. It's got the B12, it's got the D, it's got the omega-3, it's got everything I need. I also do recommend using iodized salt. Iodized salt will give you your recommended daily value of iodine. If you have an iodine deficiency, that will turn into a thyroid issue. So make sure you have enough iodine. It's not a supplement, but it is in the salt. So I'll link the salt that I use. Now, I don't like to recommend throwing away food. So I say to give away all the non-vegan food that you have in your kitchen. Especially if you live by yourself, that's a lot easier to do because you're not having to give somebody else's food away. And I know they wouldn't like that. They would be totally mad at you. Why'd you give my food away just because you're going vegan? I'm not going vegan. Anyway, give the non-vegan food to somebody who still will eat it. I hate to just throw food in the trash, even if it is an animal product. If you can give it away, give it away. Somebody else can use that. If you're enjoying this video, make sure you leave a thumbs up. A lot of people struggle thinking that if they go vegan, that means they're never gonna be able to socialize, they're not gonna be able to go to dinner, and they're not gonna be able to eat out at restaurants. People are gonna make fun of them or look at them funny, but that's not true. When it comes to socializing, especially now in 2021, it is totally okay to be vegan. I just recommend if you're going to someone else's house and you don't think they're gonna prepare a vegan dish for you, bring at least one dish that you can enjoy and that you can also share with everybody else. And that gives them a taste of how delicious vegan food can be as well. I will say you probably want to make a vegan recipe that you already know and love and you can trust, because you don't want to show up with something that is actually not great and you don't like it and nobody likes it and now everybody thinks veganism is like the dumbest thing ever and disgusting. So keep that in mind. And when it comes to eating out, nowadays, almost every restaurant has a vegan option on the menu. Some even have a full vegan menu. Just make sure to check the menu before you go, especially if you're going with a group of people and you don't want to kind of embarrass yourself asking the waiter a lot of questions. Just check the menu ahead of time. Call the restaurant if you need. All right, now, this one is important. You have to tune out the noise from the vegan haters, from all the people in your life who think it's a terrible idea that you're going vegan. Because what do they know? Most of these people have no experience eating vegan, definitely no experience with nutrition. Most of these people look at their diets. So those are not the people you should be taking any advice from at all. So tune that out. Know that you're doing something that's better for your health, better for animals, and definitely better for the planet. And just don't worry about what the haters say. That's what I say. Now, speaking of what other people say, it is so important to find trusted sources of information. So when you have questions about nutrition or vitamins and supplements and such, you can go to trusted websites, books, people to get the answers. I highly recommend just a few: nutritionfacts.org. I'll link all these down below. Also, PCRM, the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine. And I love a little website called theworldshealthiestfoods.org. It's linked below. Love that website. It's great for foodies like me, but you learn so much about nutrition. And if anyone asks questions of you about your vegan diet, nutritionfacts.org is a really good resource for you and also a resource for someone else. So you can send them their articles or their videos. Don't get caught up in diets and fads that are all within the vegan lifestyle. I call it a vegan lifestyle rather than a diet because it is about so much more than just what you eat. It is a lifestyle. It's the clothes you wear, the ideals you have, how you go about your life and such. So don't get caught up in the diets. They will throw you off. Remember what I said, 80-20 rule is all you need to remember, that 80% should be wholesome, unprocessed foods. Beans, legumes, which include beans, whole grains, fruits, vegetables, and nuts and seeds. I mean, from that, you can just do anything, really. And my last point is to educate yourself. Just how you created a plan at the beginning for how you're gonna go about this vegan lifestyle, you also should educate yourself on an ongoing basis. I've been vegan for 10 years and I'm constantly learning more about the vegan lifestyle, but especially about nutrition, plant-based nutrition. So continue to educate yourself. Those links that I shared down below and the things I mentioned before, like PCRM and nutritionfacts.org, are great sources for educating yourself. There are also so many wonderful documentaries. My favorite one to recommend is What the Health. And I know so many people have watched that already and already become vegan. So make sure you continuously educate yourself. Keep reading, keep watching movies, listening to podcasts, and you will be successful. So there you have it, how to go vegan in under 10 minutes. I talked really fast and now I feel like I need to take a nap. But I hope I helped you guys. I hope I helped you become vegan. See, it's really not that hard. You have to plan, you have to have some really good recipes in your back pocket, which, you know, my channel is all about good recipes, and you will be successful. If you have any questions, ask them in the comment section down below. I'll answer you, but also there's a big community of Sweet Potato Soul people who will also help you and guide you along your way. If you have any other tips that I should have mentioned in this video, also make sure you share those down below as well. And if you want to share your vegan inspiring story, share that too, because who doesn't love to hear about somebody else who's already been successful and to hear how they did it? Thanks so much for watching, thanks so much for sharing, and thanks for giving this video a thumbs up. I will see you guys next week. Bye!